Hello, namaste, konnichiwa, welcome to Sunny Sensei. In this lesson, we will prove a fundamental property of parallelograms. A diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. I will prove this theorem twice, each time using a different approach. And there is also an interesting challenge waiting for you at the end. Let's get started with the first proof. So, what do we have? We have a parallelogram A, B, C, D with diagonal BD. Our goal is to prove that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CDB. For the proof, we start with triangles ABD and CDB. First, we know that opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. So, AD equals CB. This is equation 1. Next, we use another important property of parallelograms. Opposite angles in a parallelogram are equal. This means angle BAD equals angle DCB. This is equation 2. Side AB is opposite to side CD. So AB equals CD. This is equation 3. We have two pairs of equal corresponding sides, and the included angles are also equal. So, by the SAS congruence criterion, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CDB. Before we move to the second proof, notice that we have used two important properties of parallelogram in this proof. First, opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Second, opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. However, for our second proof, we won't use these properties. Instead, we will rely on just one fundamental property of parallelograms. The opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel. Alright, let's now move to the second proof. Once again, we have a parallelogram ABCD with diagonal BD. We will prove that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CDB. For the proof, we start with triangles ABD and CDB. We know that opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel. So, AD is parallel to BC. We also have a transversal BD that intersects both these parallel lines, AD and BC. This means that angle ADB equals angle CBD. Why? These are alternate interior angles. This is equation 1. Now, BD equals DB. They are the same side. This is equation 2. Going back to the primary property of parallelograms, we know that opposite sides AB and DC are parallel. Now, with DD as the transversal, alternate interior angles, angle ABD and angle CDB are equal. This is equation 3. We have two pairs of equal corresponding angles, and the included sides are also equal. So, by the ASA congruence criterion, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CDB. Now that we are done with the proof, it's time to put your knowledge to the test at the challenge station. Here is the problem. In parallelogram ABCD, AP and CQ are perpendiculars from vertices A and C to diagonal BD. Given that AB equals 13 cm and QD equals 12 cm, find the length of AP. Please pause the video and give it a try. All right, let's work through it. What do we have? AP and CQ are perpendicular to BD. So, angle APB is 90 degrees and angle CQD is also 90 degrees. AB is 13 centimeters. So, the opposite side, DC, will also be 13 centimeters. QD is given as 12 centimeters. And we need to find AP. So, where do we start? Triangle QDC is a good choice. It is a right angle triangle and we already know two of its sides. We can use Pythagoras theorem to find the missing side. DC square equals QD square plus QC square. DC is 13 centimeters and QD is 12 centimeters. So, QC square is 25. Solving further, we have QC equal to 5 centimeters. Notice that I ignored the negative sign after taking the square root. We are dealing with magnitude or the length of side QC. Length can never be negative. QC is 5 centimeters. Now it's time to apply what we just proved. A diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. With BD as a diagonal, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CDB. Since the triangles are congruent, their areas are equal. So, area of triangle ABD 1 by 2 times base BD times height AP equals area of triangle CDB, half times base BD times height QC. Cancelling the common terms, we have AP equal to QC. QC is 5 centimeters. So AP also equals 5 centimeters. We are done. And with this, we have successfully completed the challenge station. If you found this lesson useful, please like, share, and subscribe to Sunny Sensei. Drop a comment with any questions or thoughts. I would love to hear from you. Thanks for watching, and I will see you again soon.